podcast, many charts from one pivot table. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Tim. Tim wanted to know if he could have many charts based on one pivot table. So when he refreshes, it refreshes them all. And I think, Tim, the solution here is we want to make sure that we have one pivot cache. C-A-C-H-E, one pivot cache. You refresh that pivot cache and all the pivot tables based on that pivot cache will update. So, for example, I'm going to insert a pivot table and I'm going to let it go to a new worksheet. That's fine. Click OK. And maybe in this one, we want to see region and revenue. All right. So, we want to show a chart based on that. All right. Fine. So, we have that one. Now, I'm going to come back to the original data set and I'm going to create a second pivot table. And by default, it's going to use the exact same pivot cache. All right, so we come here and we just say that, hey, this one's to go right there. Click OK. And maybe this one's going to show profitability by year. So I'll roll these years up to, or roll these daily dates up to years. Just years. Click OK. All right, so now I have the years. All right, so now you can keep doing this kind of thing to create multiple pivot tables. And the beautiful thing is that they are all tied to the same pivot cache. So if I do a single update back here, I'm just going to add a new record for Central DEF in 2011 for Bill as a customer. And we're just going to add 1,000,000. Straight across, which I realize doesn't make sense. But now we're going to come back here and we were at 6.7 million, 3.7 million. When I refresh either one of these pivot tables, they both refresh. So that went to 4.7, that went to 7.7. There we go. So now we just need to create a pivot chart from each of these. So pivot chart, we'll choose the type, column chart, click OK. And of course, you'll want to customize this to say that it's revenue. But we can take that chart and move the chart into a specific place. So, you know, you might put it on a new worksheet or, you know, just leave them all here on this worksheet and kind of hide the pivot tables. But let's do a pie chart. Never use the 3D pie. Oh, man. Okay. We'll arrange these. You can keep going with the same basic idea. Come back here to our underlying data. Let's make this 5 million. Update. Now it doesn't update till I click refresh. But once I click refresh on any of the pivot tables, pivot charts, they all automatically update. So it achieves the same thing that I think Tim is trying to do, although it is multiple pivot tables, but it's a single pivot cache. Well, hey, I want to thank Tim for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time.